showing back of the patient with multiple hypopigmented macule and papule of variable size and shape with irregular margins in the midline with and extending towards upward. Few of them are discrete and few of them are coalescing to form plaque. Actually, I can't differentiate properly whether it is plaque or patch. The largest one is 5 into 4 cm at the right side of upper back with surrounding erythema. The plaque is non-tender, indurated, non-scaling with no temperature gradient and not attached to underlying skin. I will check for atrophy in any of the lesion. I will do rubbing and to check the color change, or and I will do dioscopy to check it whether it's blanchable or not to the surrounding skin. Then I will examine the rest of body and I will do cutaneous examination for any other nevus or any other abnormality. I will do scalp examination, oral cavity, hands and legs and feet. My differentials are nevus inimicus, nevus depigmentosis, vitiligo and ash leaf macules. And if it is more on the patch side, then I will put LSA and hypopigmented variant of MF in my differential. Thank you.
My differentials for this case are nevus depigmentosis, nevus inimicus, vitiligo and ash leaf macules. I will make my diagnosis depending upon the history, clinical examination and Wood's lamp examination. If the lesions are present since birth, there is no change in the lesional skin on stroking. Dioscopy results in merging of the normal skin with the diseased skin. At Wood's lamp examination doesn't result in accentuation. My diagnosis will be nevus inimicus. If the lesions are present since birth and stroking of the skin, diseased skin results in increased erythema, and dioscopy doesn't result in the merging of the normal skin with the diseased skin, and there is Wood's lamp accentuation, then my diagnosis will be nevus depigmentosis. If the onset of the disease is in the recent past or after the birth, and there is a milky white accentuation of the diseased skin, then my differential would be vitiligo. And if the patient has other stigmata of tuberous sclerosis, then my diagnosis would be ash leaf macule. Depending upon the diagnosis, I will further investigate the case. For the if the patient has tuberous sclerosis complex, I will depending upon the clinical examination, I will go for the MRI brain, ECG, echocardiography, ultrasound abdomen and chest X-ray, post anterior view. And depending if the diagnosis of vitiligo, then to see association, I will and depending upon the clinical examination, I will go for blood sugar levels, thyroid antibodies, and other investigations for any concurrent autoimmune diseases. And regarding the treatment for the nevus depigmentosis, nevus inimicus and ash leaf macules, I will advise cosmetic camouflage. And for vitiligo, I will my treatment options include number one is the potent topical steroids and phototherapy. Thank you.